So we're gonna look at some more random things that you can do with plots because, you know, learning is important and stuff. So anyway, let's say that I have some random x going from, I don't know, 1 to, I don't know, I'm just making this up, 20, and there's 50 little parts of it, okay? And then I have one y, which is the cosine of that, and then I have another y, which is the, I don't know, the e to the that. All right, so that's not how I do it. I know better. It looks like that. Okay, all right, so now I want to plot. I'm going to plot xy1, and then I'm going to plot xy2, and it's going to be beautiful, and it's so amazing. I'm like, oh wow, this is really awful. Okay, so there's actually things that I could do in order to plot these both on the same thing. So basically the problem is, right, that sine like variates between -1 and 1, and the e thingy goes like that. So this is clearly something that I'm going to need to fix. So one thing that I can do in order to make this less silly looking is I can actually do something called the plot yy. Okay, now look at what, oops, except I need to close this out and redo it. Okay, so I'm going to do a plot yy. Now look at what plot yy does. You can see that it's got one thing in blue that goes from -1 to 1, and then it's got one thing in green that goes from 0 to 5 times 10 to the 8th, which is really interesting because basically what's going on is it's plotting the one on one axis and it's plotting the other on a different axis, which is really, really interesting. Well, it's interesting because it lets you, you know, it lets you see the detail in the data that you may not have been able to see before, which is actually kind of cool. So we're going to play with this kind of data set a little bit more. So let's just plot x and y2 by themselves. So this is what x and y2 look like. This is a little silly as well because it's so, so, so close to zero, and then it's really, really, really big. So something that we like to do is we like to use a log axis, a logarithmic axis. So like right now, every single one of these distances along the y-axis is equally spaced. And so one thing we can do instead of plotting it, we could use a semi-log y-axis. So basically we're going to make semi-log, so half of our graph or half of our axes are going to be logarithmic, and the one that will be logarithmic will be y. So now what you can see is this is actually a logarithmic axis. So we still have 0 to 20 here, but now you see what's going on is this goes 10 to the 0 to 10 to the 1. So the distance from here is 1 to 10. The distance here is 10 to 100, 10 to 1,000, 100 to 1,000, 1,000 to 10,000, and so on and so forth. So that actually lets us see the detail in this line, which is basically, well, since it's exactly exp and I've plotted it on a log axis, it's now just a straight line. So it allows us to see something that's kind of cool. Now I could probably do something a little more interesting with this, maybe there. So now it's not a straight line. I've got e to the x squared, so I have something that looks a little bit more like a curve. Now again, if you want to see what that looks like, if you just do a regular plot, it's going to look like that, which is still just basically impossible to see what's going on, right? So this is the advantage of using a log axis, is that it shows detail. So it's basically for things that grow at an exponential rate, which is exactly what we're looking at. And so, like I said, one of the neat things about the semi-log axis is that it's going to show that detail and show that a little bit better. So you could see, well, this is how much it changes from 1 to 10 to the 50th, which is actually really, really big. But that's okay. It's just showing us what's going on. Also, to make sure you remember, we could do a title. So I want to title this e to the, and then I'm going to go x squared. I think this is going to work. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. So this is actually e to the x squared. It'd be kind of cool just to say x squared plus 1, and just to see what it looks like, x squared plus 1. So it's e to the x squared plus 1. So you can see how we can play with the title there. But it's really cool. So you can, there's a semi-log x, there's a semi-log y. So this is semi-log y, which puts the y-axis on the logarithmic scale. I could do a semi-log x, which would be really stupid because my values only go from 10 to 20. But again, notice that it's the same distance from 1 to 10 as it is from 10 to 100. But again, this is a stupid way to do it. I could also say loglog, which would put both axes on a logarithmic scale is a little bit better, but really for the kind of data that we're looking at on here, semilogy is really going to be the best option.